r/nuclear revenge. First story. Steal from me, I'll ruin your career. I posted this in r/pro revenge and apparently it belongs here. This was about 2 years ago in college. I had just moved into a house off campus with three of my closest friends. There were two other college guys already living there. All of these guys were doing Air Force ROTC with me. Basically, you go into the military after you graduate. I really liked all of my roommates and the house. Except for one of the dudes that was already living there. He had a dog that would constant rip up, piss, shit on the carpet and he wouldn't clean it up. Furthermore, he would yell at us for leaving dirty dishes in the sink, etc. while he was the one making the vast majority of the mess. I had a job working 30 hours a week and doing school full time and doing ROTC. I had a job as a server, so I would make quite a lot of tips, $300 a week. I would leave the cash in my room, boxed up because I trusted everyone in the house. We were all going to join the military and integrity is a big thing. So I go to deposit my tips in the bank after not going for about a month, and I'm shocked when my cash deposit is only about $200, when I knew it had to be at least $1,200. I knew someone was stealing my tips then. It then made sense, because my deposits had seemed a little low for a while. I was furious, because I was barely scraping by working my ass off trying to pay for college. So I buy a security camera for my room and hide it. I get all the documents from my work regarding the tips I've made over the past few months. I continue leaving my tips in the box unconcealed as bait. I don't tell any of my roommates this. Sure enough, I leave for a trip and I get a notification on my phone. I watch as this mofo that I trusted steals about $300 in cash from me, taking only $20 bills, so I wouldn't notice. Well, the next day back from the trip, I schedule a meeting with our ROTC commander. I bring him all the evidence and video footage and tell him about my awful experiences with him in my house, with my other roommates as witnesses. Long story shorter, he got kicked out of ROTC and ruined his career. He had to pay me back about $1,000, I let him off easy, and had to pay the military back about $9,000, he had been getting paid by them for about a year. In addition, we go to an expensive school and he chose a useless major, so he is stacked high in student debt with no real way out. And finally, he had just quit his job, because he thought he could get away with stealing from me, and watching TV at home. And he had just crashed his dream car he'd been working on for a while, because he drives like an idiot. I still see him every so often on campus and smile at him. TL, Dr. Asshole roommate steals my tips, and I ended his whole career. Insert Soldier Boy vs Super Hot Fire meme here. Second story. Lady wouldn't vacate private parking space. Good luck finding your licenseless car in another country police impound lot. I have lived in an apartment complex in Lisbon, Portugal, the where is important, for the last 4 years. If anyone's from here, you'll know parking is hell. Fortunately, my building has a private garage. However, as is often the case, some parking places are more difficult to park in than others. I have one of the easier ones. Last year I was offered a job abroad and took it. Thought I'd be nice, parked my car at my parents', where they have plenty of space, and left a notice in the building elevator that went along the lines of I'm the owner of 3B and will be away for at least 6 months. Feel free to use my parking spot. Ended up being away for longer, almost a year. Came back to see my parking spot occupied, which was okay, since I offered for it to be used. Put another notice in the elevator, this time to say I was back and would use the parking spot again. Gave it 2 days and picked my car up from my parents. Went into my garage and my space was still being used. Had to park somewhere on the street and decided to give it another day. The day after, it was occupied again by the same car. Asked a couple neighbors and figured out it belonged to a lady living 2 stories above me. Went up to talk to her and she immediately got defensive and said that her parking spot is very difficult for her to park in, and since I was away for longer than I had announced, I lost the space, which is a stupid logic as the spots are bought with the apartment. It literally belongs to me. She also told me I couldn't use her parking space instead as she was using it for storage. Went to the building admin, who said he talked to her. He did, and came back shaking his head. Nothing. I sent a registered letter telling her to stop using my space, and giving her 48H. to take her car elsewhere. The next day I saw the unopened letter in the garbage bin beside the mailboxes. I ended up scouting my garage, waiting for her to leave, and would immediately park my car, hoping she'd take the hint. She didn't, and we ended up doing this dance for a few weeks, up until the day I came back to see my entire driver's side keyed. That was the final straw. I talked to a friend who owns a towing company. We chose a Saturday morning. The last few weeks she hadn't left home on Saturdays. I knew as I had been watching her car like a hawk, so I thought we'd have big chances of her not noticing anything until everything was done and towed her car. The plan initially was to leave the car just down the road, but that felt too close and too easy. Then I thought about leaving it in a city about 15 minutes away, but it still didn't feel quite right. My friend jokingly said, "Let's leave it in Madrid." FYI, Madrid is in Spain, about 600 kilometers, 375 miles, away. I knew he was joking, but Madrid did feel right. I asked if he had enough time. He had, so off we went. Once we got to Madrid we went out for lunch, strolled around the city, and waited until it got dark and the streets empty. In the meantime we had already decided on where to leave the car, a handicapped parking close to a police station. And so we did. As a bonus, my friend also took both license plates off the car. Then we drove back home. It has been 2 weeks, and I haven't seen her car since. One of these days I might leave a letter in her mailbox telling her to contact Madrid police, but in the meantime I'll enjoy being able to use my parking whenever I want to. Third story. Boy murders his father's killer. When he was 12 years old, Alam Khan saw his father killed by Mohammad Reis. 12 years later, when Khan was 24, he enacted his revenge. Reis went to Khan's house for repair work, but he didn't come back. Khan told reporters that he got Reis drunk off of liquor. He then killed him and cut Reis' body while blasting music into 12 pieces, one for every year he had to wait. The body parts were then stuffed into poly bags and dumped in the Ramganga. The body was discovered and Amir Hussain identified the corpse. Police then raided Khan's house and arrested him. TL, Doctor, hello. My name is Inigo Montoya. Fourth story. New York City bar too expensive for Midwest man. In the early 2000s, I worked in an Irish pub on 2nd Avenue and 9th Street in Manhattan. We were used to seeing Midwestern men on a business trip announce that they will get the bill. This one is one me, only to regret it when they see the bill, sticker shock, and realize that drinks in Manhattan don't cost the same as their local dive bar. Enter Ohio. BUSINESSMAN equals OB. WAITRESS equals W. ME equals ME. So, this group of guys comes in and start ordering beers. One guy, up, announces loudly to order whatever you want. This tab is on me. So, they rack up a tab of around $400 in just over 3 hours. When the bill is brought to OB, he starts yelling about being overcharged. There is no way this is our bill. We didn't drink this much. I approach the table to try to help. Me, what seems to be the problem? OB, this bitch is trying to overcharge us. She's trying to charge us for extra drinks. Me, what is the problem on the bill? OB, well, first of all, there are 6 shots on the bill. We never had any shots. Me, sir, there are 6 empty shot glasses on the table. OB, okay, maybe we had the shots, but there is no way we drank this many beers. Me, sir, there are 6 of you. You have been here for over 3 hours. At that rate, this bill says you and your friends have averaged 1 beer per 45 minutes. Does that sound outrageous to you? OB, friends of OB, it's fine, let us pay. OB, no, I will pay. M, okay. So he pays. He tips $7.37. Because this would make his expense report total out to the closest $10. After this, W comes up to me to tell me he left his wallet in the booth. She is shaking. She tells me she wants to chuck it in the trash. I tell her to hand it to me. I'll take care of this. I take the driver's license out of the wallet, put it on top, and rubber band the lot. Keep in mind, government issued ID equals FRE postage, and walk a block up the street to drop this in a USPS box. OB comes back, asking about his wallet. I tell him what I did. He goes off on me about what am I supposed to do for money? My hotel key was in there. He even threatened to call the police To which I responded, "For what? Going out of my way to make sure your belongings made it back to you?" He kept going on about how he had no money, no hotel key, no cards for the rest of his visit. I know he left before it ever occurred to him to ask, how would he get on that flight home? Welcome to New York City, motherfucker. Edit, just want to add that they ordered food as well. I didn't include that in the original post because Ob didn't complain about food costs, he only complained about the drinks. I think domestic beers were around $5, imports were around $7, and top shelf shots were around $11.